But unfortunately, there is a journalism which is ready to bail out even the corrupt government.
No, maybe both sides would be embarrassed if the truth emerges, Ashish.
I mean, this is so despicable. I mean, this is the attitude of the principal opposition party. I mean, the other day, in another TV channel, another
I'm
debate,
sorry. What is the
BJP spokesperson was in complete agreement with
to
me
cover
because
up,
we had Nair Maran and the PMO. Now, something which doesn't suit them. Have you read my 10-page story? In my 10-page story, I have condemned you, the BJP, the Congress party,
friend,
and the Samajwadi party, everybody.
You have not
your
even
party has lied.
What is the role? What is the role of Amartya?
This is a story which makes everybody look bad. This is a story which makes every political party look bad. But the attitude of the BJP has been to shoot the messenger. If you don't like anything, if something doesn't suit you, then shoot the messenger. This has been your attitude, and you say you respect the media. Your government did everything to muzzle the press. Your government did everything to muzzle Tehelka. Your government decimated Tehelka.
Friend,
I mean, a witch hunt unparalleled in the history of Indian journalism was launched by your government. And you say that you respect journalism. You say.
Okay, gentlemen, I call a truce on this issue.
I mean,
however,
the worst kind of political double speak that the BJP can resort
now,
to.
Now, what was the deal? There are a couple of questions. What was the deal?
You cannot
the
work
worst
as
kind
a journalist
of political
and
double speak that you resort
party
to. The
also.
Worst kind of political double speak.
Come.
You don't have any evidence, but still you come on national media and you make all kinds of insinuations
which
that this story was planted.
Provided?
What evidence do you have?
Okay, Ashish, let him
in
respond.
The last four,
let
in the
what
last
about the car?
4 years,
the car
4 years,
what
your government came down like a ton of bricks. What evidence did you get against Tehelka? Tell me one shred of evidence that you had against Tehelka. 4 years, you launched a massive hunt against Tehelka. Tell me. Tell me, what evidence did you have against Tehelka?
I simply have a question here tonight. Gentlemen, I'm coming here tonight. Siddharth.
Forget about what happened
one
now.
Minute,
we are
Siddharth.
Talking about cash for vote.
Siddharth.
Even in the cash for vote, even in the cash for vote, the account that Tehelka has put out has been corroborated by the reporter who conducted this sting operation in conjunction with you.
Ashish and to Siddharth Nath Singh, I appreciate the passion, but I just must intervene, gentlemen, because of want of time. I want to give everyone an equal say. And I know there are impassioned sides. My only point to you, Siddharth, and to everyone, I won't completely, if you look at it in a non-partisan way, the viewer has one question. There was a channel involved. There were two political sides involved. And obviously, the real truth has not come out. Sudhindra Kulkarni, you said, you know, way back, I think, 2009, you say, I was not the mastermind. It was another top leader,
I was the mastermind. Don't get it wrong, Arnab. I was the mastermind
you claim
of
you
this.
It was another senior BJP leader.
You know, you ask the senior BJP leader if you know the identity of that person. I want to tell you one thing, that I was fully and closely involved in exposing this scandal. I stand by everything that I did. If I did anything wrong, then I'm prepared to face consequences.
Were there other people here that didn't have the blessings of senior party leaders? Or are you taking the hit on their behalf? Are you taking the hit on their behalf?
No. That, you know, you ask the BJP leaders. I'm not in the BJP
anymore. I'm asking you, sir, because you would know. You would know, sir. If there's someone who knew, you would know. You would know what deal was there with the channel. You'd know what deal was there, on what basis the deal was there or not there. Well, tell me, sir. Come out with the truth. Tell us.
What is the main point today?
The main point is the story is not. It's right on top of the channel tonight. It says reveal the real story. My real point is tonight, Siddharth, Sudhindra Kulkarni, hold your heart and tell me. Do people know the real story?
Either you speak or you let us.
I'm asking you. I'm asking.
Okay. No, Arnab,
let him speak.
Arnab Goswami, the people know the truth. Let's not get confused, Arnab. The people know the truth. The people know that the Congress and the Congress senior leaders, along with Amar Singh, were involved in buying MPs.
Okay, now let Mr. Kulkarni respond now.
Unfortunately, by WikiLeaks,
sure.
It has been now corroborated by the arrest of Sanjeev Saxena. I don't think that the people are not aware of
then
what the truth
is. Why has one arrest happened in 3 years? Yes, Mr. Kulkarni.
Arnab, the question is that in these 3 years, Amar Singh has not been interrogated even once, either by the parliamentary committee or by the police. Why was he protected? If he was protected, obviously, it is because the government did not want the truth to come out. And which is why even his PA, even his associate was not arrested. It's only after the Supreme Court censured the Delhi police for its shoddy, inefficient interrogation that the arrest has taken place. Which only goes to prove that the government had something to hide. If the truth is that we were involved in destabilizing the government, in putting up a show of bringing our own money and showing it in parliament, then by now, but the government, you know, it doesn't take three years. This investigation could have been completed.
Maybe both sides are right. That maybe money was being paid. That's what the Tehelka story says. Money was being paid.
Whose money was it? Who gave the money?
It was Amar Singh's money.
Who was money being paid?
Was Amar Singh working on behalf of the BJP?
No, sir, there are two truths.
If you say that, then you are putting the truth on its head.
No, there are two truths. One is money was being paid. That's one allegation. The second allegation is that while money was being paid, there was also an attempt to stage manage the whole operation of money being paid. And there was a deal which went awry. That's the way
absolutely.
We understand.
You know, absolutely. If we stage managed, can we, you know, make Amar Singh our partner in stage managing? Amar Singh at that time was, and even now is, the political opponent of the BJP.
You can't make somebody take a bribe. You can make somebody give a bribe.
Be logical.
No, I'm being logical. You can't make somebody. I want to go to Mohammed. You can't make somebody take a bribe, but you can manage somebody giving a bribe.
Are you saying that Amar Singh was acting on behalf of the BJP?
No, this incident.
In giving 1 crore rupees.
Mohammed Saleem, you bring your dissent note here. I'm looking at this whole story. Some people believe this story is a closed story. Many people would like to put this whole scam behind them because there is some 400-page report which has already come out. What do you think will happen now with the Supreme Court coming in?
Now, if Supreme Court monitors this and they are doing it, now government or government agencies and police and investigating agencies, including CBI or Delhi Police, they are only doing something if they are pushed by the media or by the press or by the judiciary. So I think the BJP as a political main opposition political party and Congress as the ruling party, none of them are serious. So at least now the truth will come. Yeah. And truth is one. The nation should know, and we must go to the bottom of the truth. Yeah. And guilty must be punished.
And truth will be damning for the BJP, for the Samajwadi Party and for the Congress, yeah, for everybody. This holier than thou attitude that, you know, some politicians are adopting and political parties are taking, that it was a fight of righteousness against corruption, against evil. That's not the truth. Hamam mein sabhi nange hai. It will make look everybody bad.
I don't agree with that line, but yes.
My dear friend, do not insuade and charge on all political parties. If you have worked as an agent or a cover-up journalism for bailing out a government, do not include BJP or any other political party. Restrict yourself to Congress.
The credibility of spokespersons like you, I mean, everybody knows the kind of credibility that spokespersons, political spokespersons like you carry.
Siddharth Nath Singh, one point is here. You know, you always know this. On the news hour, we want to discuss the issue. We don't want to get personal. We have respect for all our panelists equally. We want the different points of view to come out. The issue here is, and I think one issue is also there. I think Ashish began by saying that this is a news of the world moment for Indian media. Well, the whole question here is, Sudhinder Kulkarni, I must say, you've been a journalist yourself before you became a politician. I don't know since when you get outsourced sting operations. I mean, you know, the basic rule of journalism is you do your own stings.
And
you
they launched a witch hunt against a portal which conducted a sting operation.
I don't know this
and
business
then they
of
go and,
outsourcing.
And carry a sting operation
for you
in conjunction.
But as a premise of journalism, I don't know if it works.
Let's not sidetrack this discussion. You know, the main issue is it has taken 3 years for the first arrest to take place. The people of India want to know whether it will take another 3 years for the full truth to come out. Truth must come out.
So you accept it's not come out. So you accept that the Lok Sabha committee that went into the cash for vote scam has not brought out the real truth.
The person who is arrested was acting on behalf of Amar Singh. Amar Singh himself was not a freelance player. He was acting on behalf of somebody else. Therefore, the trail must go to the people who have benefited from this. And the 2008 confidence vote which the government won, UPA won, was a fraudulent victory.
I'd like to just remind you,
Arnav,
one very interesting remark that Jaswant Singh made immediately after he was expelled from the party. He said, when he saw Suhail Hindustani and his attire and his gait, and he saw that man who was looking like a broker, a man from the street, sitting with L.K. Advani and planning this entire thing, he was so disturbed that he went back home and had a drink in the daytime. This is what Jaswant Singh said. He was a member of your own party. He was a former finance minister. I mean, now what you have to say about your own party?
Okay, now again, one sec. You see, Muhammad Saleem wrote in his dissent note.
Unfortunately, when Mr. Jaswant Singh made the statement which excites you, was not at the time when he was the member of the party. And please, let's not again. I say,
are you saying that when Jaswant
sidetrack the issue?
Does that discredit him? I mean, because he was not a member of the party, his statement doesn't carry any weight.
The government slept over it till the Supreme Court rebuked it. Now the government has made a first arrest. There is a link to Amar Singh. Amar Singh has not been.
This is exactly what Tehelka said.
BJP is not a beneficiary.
The Tehelka headline, the story, caption, the story.
The Samajwadi Party bailed out the entire
Congress. A trip and a cover up. This is exactly what we said.
There are links to it. There is a whole lot of WikiLeaks which has come up. There needs to be a serious investigative journalism. No. There needs to be a serious and a transparent, honest investigation by the crime branch.
So let this come out. There were two things. One is it was a sad day in the history of parliament. Whichever you look at it, it was an attempt at subverting our democracy. Both bribe giving and bribe taking are equal offences, as Muhammad Saleem said under the Indian Penal Code. My only question tonight is there a lack of political will? I mean, 3 years and the Supreme Court says it and you have one arrest. That's the point, isn't it, Muhammad Saleem? Is there a lack of political will to come to the bottom of this?
Yes, definitely. Because more and more big money is playing the role in our politics, in our parliament, electing members of parliament, selecting ministers, allocating portfolios. So I think when the money is involved, be it a section of media, be it the politicians, be it the investigative agencies, none of them are serious in such thing. That's why the sting operations we just conducted, it was not shown on the day of the election, on the trust vote, on 22nd July. That means the same channel is making a deal over a deal.
And for the first 1 month or 1.5 months, there was absolutely no mention of the role that Sudhin Kulkarni played, that other senior BJP leaders played. There was absolutely no mention of that role either by the BJP or by the channel concerned. It was only before the parliamentary panel when they went and testified, they started giving conflicting versions.
Was there a deal after the deal, Mr. Kulkarni? This point has come out and hence I come back to it. I was about to close, but since he made the point there and then Ashish is making it. For fairness, I must ask you, was there first a deal to do this and then a deal not to reveal the full story?
The deal was somehow to ensure the survival of the government, which had been reduced to a minority. And even before we planned and executed this whistleblowing operation, a very respected communist leader, A.B. Bardhan, took a press conference and said that opposition MPs were being offered 25 crore rupees. Which has been subsequently corroborated by WikiLeaks, which says that 4 opposition MPs were actually paid 10 crores each. So if you look at the entire thing in its totality, it goes to show that the real deal was to ensure the survival of a government which had been reduced to minority.
I mean, the same AB
please don't butt in.
Let him complete.
You complete, Ashish. Please.
And that is the issue. And the people of India expect that even after this lapse of 3 years, investigation is speeded up and all those who are guilty are punished.
This is a very, if I may say, it's a high voltage discussion we've had. And please don't jump at me, but I think there are two more. I'm saying this in a light-hearted way, so please don't jump at me for saying this. I think the answer is also, Mr. Kulkarni, the BJP should do its own journalism and maybe the media should do its own stings. And that will retain both the independence of the political party and the independence of the news channel. Maybe that's a better solution. Mm-hmm. Gentlemen, thank you very much for joining me on the... Siddharth, thank you.
Let me add here.
Yes. Okay, since you...
I fully agree with you. But unfortunately, when the entire democracy is being subverted by the ruling party and there is no means to stop them from buying and all. It is important. It's equally important for the political party, even for the journalists, and even for any
kind of raunchy tabloids,
to expose that act of the government. Okay. So therefore, do not try to put it in a box and they say it cannot be done or it has been wrongly
done. You can do your own sting and put it on the BJP website.
All the BJP did was to expose the government which was trying to subvert the democracy.
Well, I mean, you know, you could have done your own sting and put it on the BJP website. All news channels would have put it up. I think the journalism needs to remain independent, then, and political parties should not
no
find
credibility.
Well, I think it was an attempt to get credibility. Maybe that's the story. There are many lessons here. Is this a news of the world moment for Indian media? If the real story comes out, maybe it will be. Gentlemen, thank you very much. That's it on this extended session of News Hour Tonight. As I began by saying, it is wonderful to see you once again. Tomorrow evening, 9 p.m., I'll be back. And that's a promise. Good night and goodbye.